it even more. We can see this not only with Brown, who is going on with the same policies with Blair, but also with Sarkozy in France, with Prodi in Italy, with all the governments. We have the same picture also with our right-wing government in Greece. And this development, the even further involvement in this dirty war of Bush, creates new fronts and new challenges for the anti-war movement. The first challenge we had to face in Greece was to defend the Pakistani immigrants against Islamophobia. As you may know, in summer 2005, soon after the attack in London, the Greek secret police, with the help of the MI6, organized the kidnapping, interrogation, and torture of at least 28 immigrants from Pakistan. The war on terror has been brought in the West, and it puts our civil liberties and rights under attack. The first victims in this dirty war are our Muslim brothers and sisters. But because of the courage of the Pakistan community in Greece and the big mobilizations we as Stop the War Coalition in Greece have organized, the scandal of the kidnappings not only was not allowed to be covered up, but on the contrary, it caused a huge political crisis to the government and made the Secretary of Public Order and his minister to resign. Dictator Musharraf is certainly one of Bush's good allies, but also is a very good friend of Greece. This became clear when, after the failure to cover up the scandal of the kidnappings, the Greek government, cooperating with the Pakistani embassy in Athens, began the arranged prosecution of the president of the Pakistan community, Javed Aslam. They wanted to take revenge and to destroy the community and to deport its president. They failed miserably again, because we managed to organize mass demonstrations to mobilize all opposition parties, all the trade unions, the student unions, thousands of ordinary people and well-known peace activists all over the world. The Greek TUC paid 30,000 euros in order to release Javed Aslam. We won the victory in the trial last May in the Supreme Court, and we saved Javed Aslam from the prospect of disappearing somewhere in Pakistan and from there maybe in Guantanamo Bay. These attacks on the Pakistan community did not end. 2 months ago, fascist gangs attacked Pakistani immigrants in a poor neighborhood of Athens, taking courage from the racist propaganda and practice of the government, the police, and of a fascist party which is newly elected in parliament. We organized a mass demonstration in the area in order to break the fear that the fascists want to impose and to demonstrate our solidarity with our brothers and sisters from Pakistan. It is not a coincidence, after all these fights and battles we fought together, that the Pakistan community of Greece was maybe the first Pakistan community in Europe to come out and demonstrate bravely outside the Pakistan embassy in Athens only 2 days after Musharraf knew martial law. Neither it is a coincidence that on November 17th, in a demonstration to mark the anniversary of an uprising against the Greek junta in 1973, thousands of peace activists, together with hundreds of Pakistani people, demonstrated against the war in Iraq, against Musharraf junta, and against Greece's involvement in the occupation of Afghanistan. The second challenge for the anti-war movement in Greece is Afghanistan, where the Greek army has been there since 2005. But now this presence is in the process of being increased, both in numbers and in involvement. Because for the first time, the Greek soldiers will be engaging in real battles outside the safe Kabul, as NATO and the US wanted and finally succeeded. This is a dangerous escalation, which we want to stop before we see body bags with dead soldiers coming home. We demand the immediate return of the Greek army from Afghanistan. The government is trying to hide Greece's increased involvement in Afghanistan and the danger that this puts the Greek soldiers into. But even this is difficult for them. On the one hand, because the overwhelming majority of people, over 90%, are against the war. And on the other, because of the revelations made by very well-known journalists who work alongside with the Stop the War Coalition in Greece, who expose the deadly consequences of being engaged in areas where depleted uranium has been used. Until now, until at least 23 Greek officers have been ill with cancer by being exposed to depleted uranium in battlefields, mainly in Yugoslavia, but also in Afghanistan. Similar revelations in Italy about the victims of depleted uranium have helped us a lot, also as in Greece. Last but not least challenge for the anti-war movement in Greece is to close down the US and NATO military bases, particularly those in Crete Island. These bases are extremely important for the US and NATO's campaign in the Middle East. They are the largest refueling and service bases for the fleet in East Mediterranean. Until now, there have been many demonstrations in Crete Island, and we are organizing an even bigger one for the 15th of February to mark the 5th anniversary since the birth of the new superpower, our global anti-war movement. We are certain that the successful action against the establishment of the new American missiles in the Czech Republic and in Poland, as well as the action organized in Vicenza in Italy in the mid-December, as Paola Manduca said before, against the expansion of the military bases, will provide our struggles with renewed inspiration and impetus. Comrades and friends, we believe that the European governments work together with Bush, and all of us, the anti-war movement in Europe, can stop them. In the last few days, the workers in Greece have taken to the streets against the new pensions bill which the government wants to pass. They continue a very big struggle, a struggle from where the students left it last year, when they occupied all universities and forced the right-wing government to retreat over the privatization of higher education. This week, we're on strike. The primary, secondary, and high school teachers, the doctors, and civil engineers of the public sector. The journalists organized the biggest action in the last 30 years, and all together, we are trying to organize a historic general strike on 12th of December, which will decide the fate of new democracy, the right-wing government in Greece. The anti-war movement will be there, will participate in this general strike to demand an end to the armament, an end to all this expenditure on the arms, to demand schools and pensions and not bombs. In Greece, we'll do our best to get rid of our government, and I think that today's conference will give us more strength to go on with this fight. Thanks a lot.